Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be telling you guys all about the products that I've been using recently to help with my hyperpigmentation. So for the longest, I've been having hyperpigmentation concerns, especially on my, what side is that again? On some, yeah, around here. I only recently started using some products that have basically helped to clear or is clearing the hyperpigmentation because it is work in progress. The reason why I'm doing this video is that I've got a lot of requests from you guys to show you my skincare routine, to show you what I've been doing to help alleviate the hyperpigmentation issues. So I'm going to start with my nighttime routine. On the days that I have makeup on, I double cleanse. First of all, I use micellar water. I use the micellar water with a cotton pad, and then I wipe down the makeup, and then I go in with my Sarah Chapman beauty balm, or cleansing balm rather, to, you know, double cleanse my face. So after using that, I go in with simple micellar water gel wash. And yes, I did a review on that gel wash. I'll put the link here for you to check out. Then I will go in with my simple face toner. And the reason why I use a lot of simple products is that they have no fragrance. Most times fragrance tends to irritate the skin. So after toning my skin, then I go in with the main product that has been super helpful. This is a prescription product right here, and it's the Dermatica. Dermatica is an online based dermatological brand. They prescribe the tretinoin 0.5% plus hydroquinone. What they do is, like, monthly they send you your prescription. Started using this tretinoin with hydroquinone 4%, and hydroquinone is known to lighten the skin. I've used it for a month plus. It is really, really potent, and it's prescription. You can't get this over the counter. This product is the main product that helped to alleviate the hyperpigmentation that I've been battling with. After about a month, I noticed a significant difference, but I was glad that it was fading. The hyperpigmentation was fading, but I wasn't happy that my face was getting lighter. So I emailed them to let them know my concerns, and they were like, okay, that's not a problem, that they will change my prescription to still tretinoin instead of hydroquinone. This time we'll change it to niacinamide, and niacinamide is also known to brighten the skin. Niacinamide has a lot of benefits on the skin. When I'm done applying this, I wait for a while. Most times I end here. So the steps are, I wash my face, I tone my face, then I apply this. So just 1, 2, 3, that's it. Then if I want extra moisture on my skin, I will then, maybe after about 40 minutes, go on to applying moisturizer on the skin, or I will apply my water sleeping mask, and that's it. And then for my morning skincare routine, I wash my face either with the CeraVe facial cleanser, or the simple micellar gel wash, or the Cosrx low pH morning gel wash. Anyone, that the one that's closest to me. And if you'd like to see reviews on these products that I just mentioned, the face washes, I will put the link there. And I hope this side I'm even putting my hand, I'm actually right, so I'll put the link there anyway. Then I tone my face with the same simple facial toner. Then I apply my hyaluronic acid from The Ordinary. And then after using the hyaluronic acid, I let it sink into my skin. Then maybe after about 5 minutes, I proceed to applying the Drunk Elephant Vitamin C Serum I use. And I have done a review on that. So if you'd like to see what I have to say about this vitamin C serum, I'll put the link somewhere there as well for you to check out. So it's supposed to help with pigmentation on the skin. When I'm done with vitamin C, I'll go on to moisturizing my face. The final step, which is major key, which I do not joke with, is my sunscreen, La Roche-Posay SPF 50. Broad spectrum SPF on my face. Like, there's no single day that goes by that I don't use this. You totally have to use your SPF no matter what your skincare regimen. Like, if you don't use it, trust me, you'll be messing with your skin. You wouldn't see any improvement. And then if you're using acids on your skin, be sure to wear SPF, because if you do not wear SPF, just imagine, I always say this, imagine having a house, a beautiful house and everything, spending a lot of money building a house, and then you do not have a roof, you're just going to ruin the house. When rain comes, when sun shines, it's going to mess the house up. So you totally need your SPF, especially if you're using all these very, very potent skincare products, your vitamin C's, the retinoids, retinols, retin A's, and you name it. You totally need to protect your skin from the sun. I've also done a video on sunscreens as well, and I'll put the link somewhere there for you to check out. Let me just go through it again. So in the morning, I wash my face, I tone, I use my hyaluronic acid, which helps attract moisture to my skin. Then after that, I layer on either vitamin C or niacinamide on the skin. Both of them do almost very similar things. And then I moisturize and I end everything up with an SPF. So this is basically how I've been able to take care of my hyperpigmentation. Like I said, it's work in progress. I'll let you guys know how it goes when I change my skincare products, when I possibly change the prescription. I'll let you know how it goes. Be sure to check with your esthetician or dermatologist or any skin expert before you start any journey, so that you do not end up ruining your skin. Yes. This has to be for this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, let me know in the comment section below. And if you've got any questions, don't hesitate to ask. And if you're here to subscribe, be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.